Welcome to Game Dev Guidance. Part 2 of the character controller tutorial covers the implementation of gravity and jumping mechanics. Jumping is a fundamental gameplay mechanic in 3D video games that serves several crucial purposes, making it an essential element in the gaming experience. If you're enjoying the quest so far, why not join our party? Like this video to boost our morale and subscribe to stay in the loop for all our future quests. Gravity in games is like the uninvited party guest who always shows up, whether you like it or not. But this uninvited guest actually brings the fun. Let's add the fun and gravity to our script. Add a private float variable beneath character controller called downward velocity. This will store the player's velocity on the y-axis. Now, in the update method, just before we call the character controller's move method, we need to check if the player is on the ground. Is grounded will return true if the player is touching the ground, and false otherwise. If we are grounded, let's add a bit of velocity downward at the ground. This will lock the player to the ground for certain slope scenarios. If the player is technically in the air, we'll need to add Unity's built-in gravity to the downward velocity variable, making sure to multiply by time.deltaTime to ensure frame rate independence. To witness the gravity in full effect, let's set the y-axis of velocity equal to downward velocity before calling the move method on the character controller. As you can see, gravity has now joined the party. It looks like the player might be enjoying the party a little too much though. Let's hop back into Visual Studio and straighten that up. Using velocity as the parameter for look rotation was fine until we needed to use the y-axis for gravity. To fix this, we'll create a new vector 3, passing in the x value of velocity for the x-axis, 0 for the y-axis, then the z value of velocity for the z-axis. It seems our player has sobered up a bit and is walking straight once again. Excellent. Now, before we get to jumping, let's add a custom gravity multiplier. Create another float variable underneath rotation speed and call it gravity multiplier. Set the default value to 2. On the line of code where we add to the downward velocity, multiply the physics gravity by the gravity multiplier. We are now falling at 2 times the speed of Unity's built-in physics engine. To really notice the difference, change the gravity multiplier to 0.25. This will set the player's gravity to 25% of the physics engine. Our player is looking as light as a feather. We could also set the multiplier to be 10 times stronger than Unity's default gravity system. Now we're almost as heavy as your mom. Haha, just kidding, but for real. All jokes aside, let's get our player jumping. Since we only want our player to jump when grounded, it's safe to say we should implement the jumping functionality right here. First off, we start by checking if the jump button has been pressed down. If it has, we need to assign a positive number to downward velocity to counteract the negative gravity applied from the line of code above. Save the script and head back to Unity. As you can see, our player now has the basic ability to jump. Take just a second and think how we can implement a custom jump force for our player that we can set and edit from the inspector. All right, let's get her done. Under gravity multiplier, create a new float, jump force, and initialize it as 10. Now replace the hard-coded value for our new jump force variable. Save the script and head back to Unity. Try and set jump force to a bigger value in the inspector and see the glory in action. One of my favorite parts of game development is fine-tuning my scripts to give my player the perfect level of control. This part seems a lot like artwork, where you can put in endless hours and still not quite be finished, but a little better than before. Speaking of fine-tuning, let's add another level of control. When the user releases the jump button and our player is in the air traveling in the upward direction, we should cancel the jump action and start the player's descent. Multiplying the downward velocity by 0.5 will cut the jump velocity in half and give the user total control over their jumps. Controlled jumping mechanics can enhance gameplay by giving players more agency and precision in their movements, whether it's for platforming challenges, exploration, or combat encounters. Here's a list of games that also use this mechanic. Super Mario 64, The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild, Celeste, and Hollow Knight. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to hit that like button to show your support and help others discover this content. For more tutorials and exciting content, be sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell. Together, we'll keep learning and growing in the world of game development.